insurers operating in the Commonwealth of Independent States are facing a volatile operating environment against a backdrop of merger and acquisition activity. I'm Yvette Essen for AM Best TV, and I'm joined by Valeria Ermakova, Senior Financial Analyst for AM Best, to talk about a report we recently published on the CIS. Can we talk about that operating environment with regards to it being volatile and the challenges that companies are facing?
Well, we think insurance companies in the CIS region face volatile operating environment. And whilst the overall economy in the CIS has improved compared to prior years, when it was affected by things like the low oil prices or the Russian sanctions, challenges for the insurance industry still remain. Amongst those challenges, we note limited investment options. The capital markets in the CIS are relatively underdeveloped compared to Western economies, and as a result, insurance companies' holdings are often subject to weak credit quality or significant concentrations, including to affiliated assets. Secondly, there are some challenges to do with the evolving regulatory environment. Now, regulatory developments can be both positive and negative. On the positive side, we note some efforts made by local regulators to improve capital and risk management standards in the region. And in the report, we give an example of the National Bank of Kazakhstan, which has been focusing its attention recently on insurance companies' capital adequacy, investment concentration, and underwriting standards. These are all positive changes in our opinion. However, frequent regulatory modifications can actually put operational strain on insurance companies and lead to earnings volatility, as companies have to continually adapt to the changing requirements.
So there are quite a few different challenges there for companies in the CIS, but how are they responding to these?
In terms of investments, like I mentioned, the regulation has actually helped to an extent, because it encouraged companies to think more prudently about their asset quality and asset diversification. However, given the weak local currency in some of these countries, what we often see is that insurance companies hold significant foreign currency assets as a way to hedge against the local currency depreciation and claims inflation, so things that can negatively affect their technical performance. And whilst we have seen companies recording significant foreign exchange gains, we remain cautious about this strategy, especially given the still limited risk controls around the asset liability management in the region.
Now, AM Best does rate a number of companies in the CIS region. Can you explain to me where are those companies based and what was the ratings activity like last year in 2018?
We rate a number of companies in Kazakhstan, Russia, and Azerbaijan, and we also monitor insurance trends and economic developments in the rest of the CIS. In terms of our rating activity in 2018, just over half of rating actions were affirmations, with the rest being rating upgrades and rating downgrades. We have also put a number of ratings under review, for example, where there was an announcement of a merger or an acquisition. And we also issued comments on a number of ratings where there was a significant event that was deemed material for the company but didn't affect its rating fundamentals. Now, when we compare ratings activity in the CIS to some other regions, it really highlights the volatility inherent in the CIS compared to other countries where we usually see a much higher share of rating affirmations.
You mentioned merger and acquisition activity there. There has been a trend in the last few years where companies are consolidating. Can you explain to me what are the drivers for industry consolidation and do we expect this trend going forward?
You're right. M&A has been a feature particularly apparent in the CIS in recent years, and we see a number of different drivers for M&As. Firstly, the typically high costs of acquiring business in the CIS and the relatively high claims inflation have put pressure on the technical results of insurance companies. And as a result, they are trying to achieve the economies of scale by perhaps acquiring another company's portfolio or acquiring a whole company. Secondly, a number of M&As have been driven by consolidation by the banks that own insurance companies, and we have seen that both in life and non-life segments. And then lastly, the increased regulatory scrutiny that I mentioned at the beginning has also resulted in some companies voluntarily exiting the market, which also led to a higher industry consolidation. Looking ahead, we expect this trend of market consolidation to continue. We think that smaller market players are likely to struggle to sustain their technical results and capital adequacy, whilst larger participants with established brands and much stronger risk controls are likely to sustain increased regulatory scrutiny.
A copy of AM Best report looking at trends within the CIS region can be found on ambest.com. For AM Best TV, I'm Yvette Essence.